NATO troops have been deployed to the Finnmark region of Norway for a series of joint military exercises. NATO troops are training only 160 kilometers or 100 miles to the Russian border. A total of 8,000 NATO troops were taking part in the military drill aimed at defending from Russian aggression. In the military drill, there was 700 troops from the US Marine Corps, the US Army and the British Royal Marines, who have been integrated into Norwegian military units. The British and American troops took part in the preparation exercise to adapt to the harsh Norwegian weather. The joint Viking 2017 military exercise, which involved the British, American and Norwegian troops. According to the Norwegian Armed Forces website, the primary goal of the military exercise was to practice crisis management and the defense of Norway. They did not specify the enemy directly, but it should be obvious to everyone who is their enemy. Pentagon insists more troops needed to counter Russian threat in Europe. Military officials continue to play the wild Russian card in order to lobby for more political, economic, and strategic support from the leaders in Washington. The US European command is in need of a greater force to stop Putin from invading the rest of Europe. The additional military forces could come in a form of an armored division of ground troops combined with relocating sea-based assets closer to Russia. This isn't the first time the Pentagon has played on lawmakers' fears to ask for more money, and is probably not the last either. When we have the record number of the US troops conducting joint military drills in Poland, the US generals in Europe are suggesting that they need an additional division, and also they will need an armored and mechanized brigade to defend from Russian aggression. Referring to Russia, Russian troops are using very similar weapon systems that can either be conventional or nuclear. And secondly, within Russian military doctrine, Russians have made a statement openly that Russia sees the use of nuclear tactical capabilities within a conventional conflict. In simple words, in the case if NATO will engage even into a small military confrontation against Russia, Putin can use nukes against NATO in Europe. Live firing and GPS denial military operations were announced in Scotland as NATO launched one of the largest war games. Massive military exercises with thousands of service personnel involved have kicked off near the coast of Scotland. Can you see that NATO war games and military training is spread all over Europe? Just raise the simple question, what is the main point of those military games, training and drills on the Russian border with Europe? Several countries were taking part in NATO's multinational Joint Warrior military training, which this time included the Royal Navy's first large-scale cyber war games. Thousands of military personnel from the UK, the US, France, Germany, Sweden, Estonia and other NATO allies have been deployed to Scotland. They are preparing for something huge, there is no doubt about that. All three branches of the UK military and other NATO allied forces were taking part in the military exercise. GPS denial operations and live firing military exercise were performed very close to real war game scenario. A warning has been released for local marine users by the Royal Navy, which said that although much of the activity occurs well offshore, civilians should be aware of elements of the military exercise which they may encounter. Let me remind you that in Russia, all the internet infrastructure is owned directly and indirectly by the Hidden Hand. Germany is the first NATO member country to launch a cyber command center with 13,500 personnel to shield from cyber attacks. Germany is the first NATO state to launch a self-contained cyber command unit designed to protect IT and weapon systems from a growing cyber attacks. The Bundeswehr Cyber and Information Space, or CIR, will have a status equal to that of the Army, Navy and Air Force. Lieutenant General Ludwig Leinos, CIR's new commander, told to German news. On April 1st, alongside the classic force of the Army, Navy and Air Force, the new Cyber and International Space, or CIRC, command center was created. Based in the former West German capital of Bonn, CIRC will start off with 268 specialists, but will grow to 13,500 military and civilian personnel by July of 2017. If the situation was not serious enough, let me ask you, what is the point to create such a cyber defense army unit? CIRC will correspond to the personnel strength of the Navy. CIRC will operate and protect the military's own infrastructure and computer-assisted weapon systems. Stressing that the center would also focus on war game offensive skills and capabilities. To be able to defend yourself, one has to know which option for attack exists out there. Attacks on the Bundeswehr's computer network occur on a daily basis. In the first 9 weeks of this year alone, the IT systems were targeted at least 284,000 times. In my old video, I was talking about that the Hidden Hand has four wild cards available to them to destroy Putin. One of those wild cards was to use cyber attacks to destroy nuclear power plants in Russia and in Europe. This video has to be deleted, but I will cover this story in greater detail in my new video. 2.5 billion US dollars. For the German and Dutch missile defense system. The German and Dutch militaries are working hard to create a joint missile defense task force equipped with Patriot rockets. The goal is to send a political signal to Putin. These two countries indeed to send a political signal by installing a purely defensive asset. The task force could be part of the new troops and military hardware deployment on Russia's doorstep in Eastern Europe, where NATO continues a massive build-up to reassure its Baltic member security. Now we have Germany and Netherlands who are preparing to spend hundreds of millions of dollars on the new air defense system. What is the point of that? Germany, reportedly, is to replace its short-range air defense systems. This action by Germany is sending a clear signal of the beginning of 460 million euro or $490 million procurement program over the next 5 years. Can you tell me, what is the point to invest half a billion of the US dollars into a missile defense system? Pay close attention now. According to Reuters, there would be an additional cost of 2 billion euros used at a later stage by Germany and Netherlands, where new radars and lasers to be installed. Can you tell me what is the point to invest 2.5 billion of US dollars into a missile defense system, radars and lasers? The positioning of the military assets for the coming war. Okay, let's sum up the NATO troops movement close to Russia's border. Recently we had 4,000 NATO troops who were deployed near the Russian border. Along with the US troops and 1,600 tanks and military vehicles were deployed to Netherlands. That would add another 6,400 combat troops. If you are keeping the score, we have 34,400 combat troops who have been positioned into Eastern Europe close to the border with Russia. Those troops are being prepared to fight or defend, as they say. You can call it whatever you like, but WW3 between Russia and NATO will be very deadly, especially if nukes will be used in Europe and some nuclear power plants will be destroyed. On top of that, NATO and the US has deployed a group of warships to the Black Sea. Electronic warfare training has also been announced to be part of NATO military drills, with the Royal Navy to have its first large-scale cyber war games in Scotland. The military exercise is set to protect NATO allies' warships and submarines against cyber attacks. Meanwhile, on the continent, NATO has also been on the move. As you all know that YouTube creators, when upload a new video to YouTube, are getting very little of advertising dollars. Breaking News TV is dying financially at this very moment when something huge is about to happen in our world. Please support Breaking News TV for reporting real news to you. If you like our videos, we want to ask you to donate only 1 euro, 1 dollar or 1 British pound through Patreon or through PayPal. Check the donation link below this video. Thank you for your support. NATO's massive deployment to Europe raised tensions with Russia. The Pentagon's massive deployment to Europe and the Baltic states, which has seen the US sending troops and military equipment to the region. The goal of the hidden hand is to raise tensions and increase chances of confrontation against Putin. Too many people who might be reassuring that American and NATO tanks, aircraft and troops are being deployed to region in the name of defense. But I have seen interviews with people who are actually quite disturbed by this. Because of course it will increase tensions, it will increase and escalate confrontation to the highest level. And my question is that, what we are going to do when the real war will start? When those countries have got a lot of militaries on both sides positioned. Of course, it will increase the possibility of some kind of mistake happening and then escalating into a full-scale war. The latest deployment is a part of NATO's larger effort to build up its military presence in the post-Soviet space, using Russia as a pretext to be safe and secure.